and with your spirit.
So that hymn eloquently said welcome, and so it's wonderful to see so many of the Reverend Carmelite family, so many friends of Jeff's here, above all his parents, Ivy and Philip and his brother Kevin, and Paul and Terry, co-parents, all the family's friends are here, from the Carmelite family, from both this country and Ireland, because you spent some happy years in Dublin, and it's good to see folk from Ireland, especially your great-grand Dave, who's now a deacon. So it's wonderful also that it's representatives from our different communities here in Britain. And so it's good to be here today, and it's really lovely to have the time to rejoice and be happy and to thank God and to look to the future with hope. And I think Father Patrick Keane wants to say a few words at this moment. That's it.
God loves each one of us and invites each one of us in a particular way to respond to that love, to participate in the love of the Blessed Trinity. Some are called to the marriage state and to be parents. Others called to the single life, while yet others are called to the caring or the teaching professions. But call to the variety of ministries is the call of each one of us to share in the love of God and to bring that love to others. In the words of the Carmelite rule, in many and varied ways, our holy ancestors laid down how everyone, whatever their state of life, whatever their religious life they've chosen, should live in allegiance to Jesus Christ and to serve Christ faithfully, from a pure heart and a good conscience. Gerard has experienced a call to respond to this love according to the ancient tradition of the Carmelite family, a tradition that finds historical origins in the 12th century Palestine, and spiritual origins going back into the biblical tradition of the prophet Elijah. Carmelite spirituality is characterized by two features. The first is its Elijah tradition, which the Carmelites developed living as they did on Mount Carmel, the scene of the great prophet's deeds. In the reading of the first book of Kings, we will hear of the contemplative attitude which led Elijah to encounter with God. The second characteristic of Carmelite spirituality is an intimacy with Mary in our spiritual life, eloquently witnessed to by the title of We Being Her Brothers, and the dedication of the first church on Mount Carmel to her honor. Carmelites live in allegiance to Jesus Christ through a commitment to seek the face of the living God through fraternity and through service in the midst of the people. In many ways, religious community life is very similar to that of the natural family. One of the reasons why people join the religious order rather than live a solitary life is the need for companionship and the support of others. Also, we feel the need to work together as a team. Like family life, we have the challenge of getting on together in a positive way. Neither community nor family life can work if we are selfish, self-centered. Living together provides a great scope for human Christian growth in love, in tolerance and mercy. Members of a religious community don't choose to live together with whom they don't choose with whom they're going to live. And they are not bound either by blood ties. Instead, people of different ages and temperaments are gathered together by God and our superiors and are expected to make the best of it. But with all our differences, we share a common outlook on life and are united by professing the same vows. The life of a friar is not the life which reflects the world, but the life which embraces all the good that God has gifted to the world, and seeking to promote the image of God in every person, and to show to the world the reality of God's peace and justice. And so the Carmelite seeks to live a life which builds up a contemplative attitude, which in turn fashions and supports a life of prayer, fraternity, and service. A vow is a solemn promise underpinning the commitment to God or to another person. The three long-established vows which Gerard will profess today of poverty, chastity, and obedience. And by means of these vows, both dimensions of the religious profession, the prophetic stance toward the world, and the commitment to the transformation of the world in Christ, are specified. In each of the vows, we see some pillar of human society left behind, surrendered. We give up the usual things that tell us who we are, and that we matter, and that our lives are going somewhere. A vow is a public statement of confidence in the love of God. A confidence that what God offers is given in abundance if we have the courage to accept it. Our liturgy today is Gerard's acceptance of God's love, which he learned among family in his family during his years of study and work, and in his living of a community of life among Carmelites and the poor people they serve.
Thank you very much, Matt. You should all stand now. As we begin every liturgy, we say, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's ask the Lord to give the healing and the health and the strength that each one of us needs at this moment, so that we can really put on Jesus Christ and die to all that is not Christ-like.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison.
Kyrie.
Kyrie.
Then the words of the Lord came to him, saying, "What are you doing here, Elijah?" He answered, "I have been very zealous for the Lord God host, for the Israelites, for the forsaken your covenant, thrown down your altars, and killed your prophets with the sword. I alone am left, and they are seeking my life to take it away." He said, "Go out and stand on the mountain before the Lord, for the Lord is about to pass by." Now there was a great wind, so strong it was splitting mountains and breaking rocks in pieces before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind had an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, the fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a sound of sheer silence. When Elijah heard it, he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood at the entrance of the cave. Then there came a voice to him that said, "What are you doing here, Elijah?" He answered, "I have been very zealous for the Lord, the God of hosts." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body you have many members, and not all the members have the same function, so we, who are many, are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith, in ministry, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness. Let love be genuine, hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good, love one another with mutual affection, outdo one another in showing love. Do not lag in zeal, be ardent in spirit, serve the Lord, rejoice in hope, be patient in suffering, persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints, extend hospitality to strangers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you,
and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. Let us acclaim the gospel in song.
Let Gerard Walsh, who is to make the solemn profession of vows, please come forward.
Present.
Beloved brother, what do you ask of God and his holy church?
Through the mercy of God, I have learned the meaning of a life dedicated to him, through the vows, by living a Christian community. Therefore, I humbly ask that for the glory of God and the service of the church, I may make my solemn profession in the order of the brothers of the Blessed Mary, Virgin Mary, of our own father.
Thanks be to God. Being transformed,
we realise that this is not for me so that I feel good, but to give me the possibility of being the hands and the feet and the presence of Jesus Christ to others, to use my gifts in a generous way. And one of the things that our Lord stresses is the fact that in this community there's no superior person, there's a servant, the one who serves. And in our Carmelite tradition we talk about a prior who is the first in the community, but who cares for the community. And in our communities we are brothers and sisters, because the Carmelite family goes beyond the friars. There are the nuns and so many members of the Carmelite family that make a richness. But in all of our Carmelite expressions, there's a great sense of the love of God expressed in friendship. You are my friends now. But if we give loving service, we break through the barriers of social convention and come to something beautiful and good. And so I pray that you, Jed, you will be able to put on Christ in a significant way. The gifts that you have shown already will flourish, and that you will be somebody who brings through your warmth, through your sympathy, something which will build community, because it's in the little things, the gentleness, the thoughtfulness, the putting oneself out in a way that's not on my being, but just beautifully and aimed. And so I pray that you will bring these gifts which I've seen in you into community, and so that wherever you are, you will be able to enable that sense of intimate friendship that the Lord wants to be lived out in practicalities. So that I ask God to bless you. Thank God for all that your family have done to bring you to this day, all that the friars of the formation team, especially in York and Kevin as well, have done to help you. And also it's one significant part of your life, because of your links with radiography, with hospitals, you've been a great presence in Lourdes. And it's good to see these from Lourdes here today, because I think that what happens there is something very beautiful for God. So let's be people of hope, and even if it's a little bit of a dark autumn day, there is a golden element in every autumn, and especially here at Aylesford, as we look at the silver birches, and as they stand proud with their golden leaves, it gives us even more sense of the abundance of goodness through God to be known for. So bless you. Thanks be to God. So I'm now going to ask you some questions. And so, dear Mother, my baptism, you're already dead to sin, consecrated to the Lord. Do you wish to draw more closely to him by some confession?
I do.
Do you wish by God's grace to embrace and follow unto death that same life of perfect chastity, poverty, and obedience, which Christ the Lord and his virgin mother chose to follow?
I do.
Following the example of the prophet Elijah, do you wish to live constantly in the presence of God, to serve God with zeal in the work of the Church?
I do.
Following the example of obeying the Virgin Mother of God, do you wish to spend your life in the unremitting service of Jesus Christ?
I do.
And through the intercession of Blessed Virgin Mary, may God complete in you what God brought you into our midst to accomplish.
Thanks be to God.
So we go to bless the Almighty Father. We may pour out his blessing on this service, is called to follow Christ perfectly. May God strengthen Gerard in his resolve.
For those who are able, let us kneel in prayer.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Friar, Saint Felicity.
Pray for us.
Blessed Titus Brandsman.
Pray for us.
Saint Teresa Benedicta of the Cross.
Pray for us.
Saint Margaret Clitheroe.
Pray for us.
Saint Thomas More.
Pray for us.
All you holy martyrs of Christ.
Pray for us.
Saint Gregory.
Pray for us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Reward the family of this servant for the gift they have given you.
purify him of all stain of sin, and invade him with divine power. We ask this through Christ
our Lord. Amen.
God, source and fount of all holiness, you have loved those whom you created so much that you have made them sharers in your divine nature. By the Son of Adam, that the sins of the world could change or destroy your divine plan. At the beginning of time, you chose Abel to be an example of my birth for us. Among the Jews, your chosen people, you raised up men and women outstanding in holiness and prominent in virtue. Blessed among these is the most blessed Virgin Mary, daughter of Zion. On her chaste womb came forth your word, made flesh to the life of the world, Jesus Christ our Lord. He is the model of all holiness. Father, your Son Jesus made himself poor that we might become rich. He took the form of a slave to make us free. By the paschal mystery of his boundless love, he redeemed the world, made it holy, and sanctified the church, to which he promised the gifts of the Spirit. With the promptings of the Paraclete, you have drawn innumerable sons and daughters to follow Christ. Drawn by the strong and welcome bonds of love, they have left all things and given themselves completely to the service of all. Be pleased, Lord, then, to look upon this your servant, whom you call by your heavenly prophets. Send upon him the spirit of holiness, so that he may faithfully fulfill what he's promised with joy. May he contemplate with love and diligent follow the divine master. Lord, may our solid chastity, joyful poverty and generous obedience be his. And may he do the things which pleases you with humility, serve you with meekness, and cling to you with love. May he be patient in times of sorrow, firm in faith, joyful in hope, and strong in love. May his life build up the church, promote the good of all, and be a clear sign of the good things of heaven. Lord, Holy Father, be pleased to guide and protect the servant of yours. And when he comes before the judgment seat of your Son, be his recompense and reward. There may he rejoice at the completion of his labours, and strengthened in your love, may he enjoy the fellowship of the saints, with whom he will offer you everlasting honour and glory. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So Jeremy is now going to receive a sign of peace from his brothers. came, Son of the Virgin Mother, made for us blessed and pure of heart, and taught us by his own life the perfection of chastity. He chose always to fulfill your holy will, and became obedient even to die for us, offering himself to you as a perfect sacrifice. He consecrated more closely to your service those who have been all things for your sake, and promised that they would find the heavenly treasure. And so, in the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as, without end, we acclaim.
Trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant peace in our day. For by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the joyful hope of the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your friends, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look, not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. The Communion Antiphon. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Blessed is the one who hopes in God.
It is for me, Gerard.